This is part of the new war on drugs in the Philippines. Police and a local government official going house to house, calling out residents by name.
The authorities call these operations knock and plead. They go door to door, inviting suspected drug users and dealers to voluntarily surrender themselves to the authorities. And so far, we haven't seen anybody turn down the invitation.
Police lead suspects back to town hall. Here, urine tests, fingerprints, and mug shots look an awful lot like procedures for an arrest, until the new arrivals are instructed to take this oath.
I voluntarily surrender to the police and government authorities. That I am an illegal drug user.
More than half a million Filipinos have turned themselves in this way in just 7 weeks, says the country's brand new national police chief. With no evidence, arrest warrant, or trial, many of them will just end up on a watch list.
We have zero tolerance for drugs. So as much as possible, we want to be, to have a drugless society.
Is that realistic?
No, it cannot be achieved.
The country's largest government-run drug rehabilitation center is crowded and overwhelmed, says the head doctor. He says he's seen a sudden surge in new patients.
30 new patients a day, and are they telling you why they're coming?
Most of them are here because of fear.
Fear?
Fear. What's going on outside, the government's actions, especially the PNP and
the police, the crackdown.
It's made them fear that they might be either incarcerated or worse, even killed.
Since the Philippines president launched his war on drugs on July 1st, police say they've killed at least 659 people across the country.
Are the police being ordered to kill suspected drug dealers?
We have to kill them if they endanger our lives.
Human rights groups are sounding the alarm about the growing body count and what that means for the rule of law. While some local government officials are worried about other new logistical problems.
I never thought that this would happen. I never thought that this would be overpopulated.
Cells in the brand new Tanawan City Jail, built to hold 30 prisoners, now holding more than 50. Many of whom were recently arrested on drug charges.
Is there room in the prisons, in the jails, in the court system for these thousands of new suspects?
They have to do like that inside the prison cells. Yeah, they're stuck inside.
In his rush to combat drugs, this country's top cop seems to have little time for the idea that a suspect is presumed innocent until proven guilty. Ivan Watson, CNN, Manila.